I am ready to get started on, I'm making for this version, it's going to be the full coverage front, and on the back I'm doing the halter back, but I'm going to do it with the swim hook. So this is cut just as mirror images, and you cut mirror of the lining and mirror of your main fabric. And let's see. So you'll also, on the front, you're going to want to cut out your lining, and that's mirror images. Mark your dot, your darts on both your main and on this one. I also like to mark my center points, and that's those. And then you're also going to want to cut out your, I'm doing a halter tie on this one, so I cut out the halter tie since I'm doing the halter back. So anytime that you cut out any of the either piece 6 or piece 8, you'll want to cut out the halter extensions. Those are the ones that go around your neck, and which is different than the tie back. The tie back is what would clasp in your mid back. Okay, and then on all versions, you're going to need a top casing. And you just decide which line that you're going to cut based on whether you're doing the hook on the back or any other kind of version. So, and lastly, I'm going to be doing the tie in the front, and this is completely decorative. You can add it to any of the views that you like, any of the front views. So it's just an extra piece that is added into the side seam. And whenever you sew that together, that allows you to wrap it around your front and tie it. So you're going to cut out 2 sets of mirror images to give you 4 total. And that's for piece number 4. So now we're ready to get started. The first thing that we're going to do is prepare our front. And to prepare our front, we will get out our main and our lining. And this is true for any of the front versions that you choose. You either need to gather between the 2 dots, or you need to sew your darts. So you're gonna, if you're gonna sew your darts, you're gonna just put it right side together. And so those for both. Once you've sewn your darts, you're going to need to hem the edges of your lining. So that means that you're gonna turn the side, let me make sure it's on camera. You're gonna turn this side under, and you're gonna under 1/2 inch, and you're gonna hem it. And that is, so your front and your lining are the same. The only difference is that your lining is gonna have this area that's hemmed back so that you can put cups inside of it. And even if you're not sure whether you're gonna use cups or you don't even have any, I would still highly recommend having this just in case you ever do wanna add them. You can grab them on Amazon, or you can see them in, you know, any store, and or sewing supply place like WOWAC or other places. You can always get them down the road if you realize that you need that modesty in your cups, or if you need some extra lift. Anyways, let's get started what we're supposed to be doing. We're going to start with sewing our darts, and now that I have prepared my front lining with my darts and hemming both sides, and I prepared my main front with my 2 darts and bust darts, I'm going to prepare my tie front overlay. And if you're sewing this version and you don't want the tie front overlay, then you can just skip the next few minutes of this video. So what you're going to do is get 2 mirrored pairs, and you're going to get the 2 mirrored pairs, and you're going to put them right sides together. And you're going to sew, I'm going to use my serger for this step. You're going to sew everything here. I'm going to point the camera down so you can see what I'm talking about on your 2 mirrored steps. You're going to sew all, you're going to sew 3 sides of this. You're going to sew starting here, and then this long curved edge, this short edge, and then you're going to then sew this bottom. But you are not, do not sew right here or right here. Ask me how I know that. Okay, so we're gonna do that on both. I accidentally sewed this part once, and I was like, why does this not look the way I thought it was? Okay, so we're gonna do this with our serger, or if you don't have a serger, that's fine. You can use a stretch stitch on your sewing machine. Now that we have prepared our front pieces and our front overlay, I just wanted to show you what it looks like sewn. See how I left this part unsewn, and I sewed the long edges and then this little short edge here. And now you're going to flip both of them to the right side. And then once we have them flip to the right side, where we can then sew our side seams. So whatever back option you've decided on is going to be the first piece that you grab. Still turning this right side. I'm looking around for my chopstick. A chopstick always helps you. If you have some kind of a turning tool or a chopstick, I always use these to get a nice good point. And if you use a good stretch stitch, you can kind of do this and get a good point on that end. Okay, and now that one's turned right side out. And now I'm going to turn this one right side out. Okay, so also once these are turned right side out, make a decision. So look at your main fabric like this and look at them. Sit there and think of, so you have two mirrored ones. This part that you didn't sew is going to be in your side seam. So it's going to match your side seam like this. So look at both of them and see which way you like is the right side to go up. So if you have one that you think you did better on, or like if you have a print and one like looks better on your print, mind you, it's going to tie in the middle. Like, so I have that option, or I have this option. So you're thinking, which one looks better? Which one? I think I like this one. So make a choice if you have a favorite. It's kind of hard to choose. Okay, so whichever one you go with, make a decision and mark whichever one you think you want the right side to be. We are sewing the side seams. The first step is to put your back right side up. The wider part on your back is the side seam, while this narrower part in the middle is the middle of your back. So this will be connected if you cut on the fold, because you don't have a hook or what ties in your back. But if you cut it to where they're two separate pieces, you'll have them separated. So put those right side up first. Now you're gonna grab your tie front, and you want the whatever side you determined is the side that you want to face out, that is the side that you are going to face down. So think about which one you decided, and then you're going to put that one down. And the top of that piece, that end zone edge is going to be at the top of that. And then the one that's hemmed, I'll show you, is away from the bottom. You see how it's not near that, because you don't want it to get caught in your bottom band when you attach that at the very end. Okay, so I'm going to put this here. And now I have the other one that I am putting on top of it. So right now we have on the bottom layer, we have our back. On the second layer, we have our tie front. Now on the next layer, we're grabbing our front, whichever front option that you've chosen. So mine is the full coverage. I'm gonna make these go farther apart. Mine is the full coverage, but if you have the deep V, then yours are not connected. So you'll have two pieces that you're putting on here, and you're connecting these side seams. You're putting this side seam down, and it's the front is facing down. Now we are going to get our front lining. So our front lining is going to the correct side of it is going to face up. And you know this one just because you can see your darts and your hemming and stuff. So that's going to face up. And then the last piece we're going to get is our back lining. And we're going to figure out whichever on your back lining. I know I've talked about it, it's harder sometimes on lining. Whichever one you want to be the right side, and you're going to put the right side of your back lining facing down. So you're going to connect those. And on this one, I know that it faces like this. I'm going to connect this here. Okay, so we have them all somewhat lined up. Grab your clips. And this is such a short seam, but you have so many things that you're connecting in this seam. So it's really important to all stay together. And I'm gonna be honest with you, I really don't like to, even though you're supposed to catch the bottom and the top of this lining and none of the middle, a lot of times I just clip it to something so I have its place marked, and I don't catch any of those seams. I wait until I baste it down and I butt it up to that seam and put it there, because it's just such a short area. It's hard. You have so many things going on in that short area. that it's really hard to get it accurate, which means you might end up ripping stitches if you really persist. So just clip it to where it's in its right place. I clipped it to the main. Okay, so now we're gonna start clipping this together. You're gonna make sure everything is lined up. So just kind of move things around. And you can go directly to your serger and serge the seam. Or if you wanna be a little more cautious, you can go to your sewing machine first, set it on the longest stitch length, and baste it really quickly together. And that will also keep it from shifting, the layers from shifting when you go to your serger. But you know, if you're just as handy on your serger as you are your regular machine, you can go ahead and have at it and go straight for your serger. So I'm clipping a ton of clips in this because there's so many layers. And I'm gonna go through these again. So you have your back facing up, your tie overlay facing down, your front main facing down, your front lining facing up, and then you have your back lining facing down. We're ready to sew. We're just gonna sew these side seams, both sides, and then we'll be ready for the next step. Okay, so I sewed my side seams, and it was very important for me to baste all these layers for it to not go bad. And it also was easier to sew from the lining side than it was onto the swim side. So if you can put your lining up, that also makes it easier. Okay, so now we are ready to turn things right side. So you're going to take your back, flip it this way, take this back, flip it this way. So all you're doing is opening up these two back pieces over your seam. And there you have it. Everything should be opened up nice and neatly now, and we are gonna baste. So here is the overlay. You're going to put the overlay on the front of the bodice, and you are going to, when we baste all of these seams, we're going to baste the overlay and that raw seam that we have not sewn on it. So there's this one raw edge left on the overlay, and you're gonna set it down and you're gonna clip. So clip the, you'll have the lining, the main, and then the overlay right here, just on this little narrow area. And then I always go through and I kind of match up points. I match up randomly, get my clips and match all these. I match up like where seam lines are. I always mark my center of things, so I'll put a clip where my centers are. And once you do this, we're gonna go through, we're gonna baste every single edge, except for you're gonna, the only part of this front overlay that you're basting is this one raw edge that's left, that's in the armhole. You're leaving the rest of it alone. Just kind of try and keep it out of the way so it doesn't get basted to anything. And then your side seam is getting shoved towards the back. Okay, so we have lots of basting to do. This is a very important step before you do any elastic, is to, you're just going to keep those edges together. You're going to push one dart to one side and then the other dart to the other. And so set your stitch length to the highest on your machine. Let's get started. You should have all of yours basted. And now if you did the deep V cup, then you have actually two pieces. Or if you did the back that was connected, then you have it connected in the back. And then you basted the only part that you caught, and this might be hard to see, but the only part that you caught of these is in this lower part of the arm side. I basted all the bottom, I basted all the edges. You can see a little bit from the lining. I did it with the lining facing up. And this is the stuff you actually don't have to do, but it's one of my, in my opinion, the most important steps in sewing swim. It really makes sewing the elastic in that much easier. Okay, we are putting elastic in now that we've finished basting. I am going to start with looking at the elastic chart. I have mine printed and I have it out. And this is the full coverage option. So I'm looking under pullover halter, and I'm gonna cut one, and mine will be 14.5. So you select your size and you're gonna cut 1 3/8 inch to cover this right here. And 14.5 is what I'm gonna cut for my neckline. Then for my arm side, I'm going to look under where it says back arm side, and I'm looking where it says halter back, and I will choose S hook or tie back. And I need to cut two, since I have two armholes, at 11 and a half. So cut your elastic and have them ready, and we're going to apply them to the wrong side. Okay, I went ahead and grabbed my arm side elastic first, and you're going to want to grab like a marker or something and mark the halfway point on your elastic, and then mark the halfway point on your arm side. Okay, we're going to go ahead and start sewing our elastic to the arm side. I went ahead and started with it right here, made sure that I caught it in my seam allowance before I start stretching, and I've got a ways to stretch. This is a rubber elastic. Okay, I have it in one arm side. You can see where I've stretched it. Once you have it in, you can go ahead and remove your basting stitches. You don't need them anymore. They're not functional in any way. They're just to help you to keep your, you know, to not have to try and keep your seam straight while you're at the exact same time stretching and applying elastic. It's really easy when you're doing that for things to get out of place or to be frustrating. But if you've basted your elastic, that's a very easy step. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply it to the other arm side. I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna half my neckline when I apply it to the neckline, and then as soon as I'm done with all the elastic that I've got to apply to the arm side and the neckline, we will be ready to top stitch. Okay, I just wanted to jump on and show you what it looks like with the elastic all applied. See, look at all that bunching on the back. That's completely normal whether you did it with a serger or a sewing machine, and that is just from stretching the elastic. So it's a good thing. You want to have it nice and tight. Keep your swimsuit on. And I just have to remove some of these basting stitches, and we are ready to top stitch. You can use your regular needle, or you can use a twin needle, or you can use your cover stitch, whichever one you feel more comfortable with. If you use your regular needle, make sure you set your stitch length and width between 2.5 and 3.0. That's usually my sweet spot, unless you have another preferred one. That's just, and then you're sewing directly over the elastic. So we're going to sew from the wrong side. Watch me remove basting stitches. Don't remove them from the bottom of the suit though, because we haven't put that elastic in. You're just removing basting stitches from where you've applied elastic, because now the elastic and that seam there is holding it firm. So I just kind of, as I go, before I top stitch, I will remove basting stitches. Okay, so I am sewing my stitch length to zigzag. I'm going to do 2.8 by 3, and I'm going to just fold that seam under, and as I apply it, you see, if you just do it where you're not stretching, it's going to gather all that right there. So you're going to need to stretch it the same, stretch your elastic the same way, and make sure that it's nice and taut and that there's no wrinkles anywhere in your fabric and that you're sewing over it like that. You have the main part of your the front and the back of your bra constructed. All we have left to do is our ties to go around our neck for the halter, and then either a tie for your back to keep your back closed, or a swim hook. And you have finished your front ties. You can tie those however you wish. And once we finish this and this, we'll also need to do our bottom band. So let's go ahead, and I'm going to do the halter ties next. And is what you're going to do, you're going to have two of these cut out, and you're going to take it and you're going to wrap it around. So you're going to take the right side to the right side, and you're going to have the middle of, so here's your neckline, and you're going to have the middle of that wrap around this tie. And you'll know it's the middle just because you can match the raw edges right here. So you're going to match the raw edges of the top, and then you're going to match these raw edges on the side, and get a clip and clip all that on there. And we're going to sew, using a 3/8 inch seam allowance across the top. So you'll sew right here. And then when you get to the corner, you'll sew down 3/8 inch. And you can just use your regular sewing machine for this using a stretch stitch. And we're gonna sew down this, kind of pushing the strap, the body of our bra, just like in. We're gonna be enclosing it. And we're gonna sew all the way until we get to the marking. There's a marking on the pattern piece. I'll show you on the pattern piece. You see these little dots. So those dots will match up when you have folded it. And that's the first one that you're going to sew to. And after you have finished sewing to the first dot, you're gonna take this and you're gonna push it out to the side, and you're going to connect the second set of dots. And once you've connected the second set of dots, you can sew all the way to the bottom here, and then sew to the end here. And I'm gonna go ahead and do that on my machine for both ties, and then I'll be back to show you what it looks like once I've sewn it down. So I have sewn my halter ties, and I'm gonna show you what it looks like now. So you can see where I sewed it here, and then I always clip this corner. It just makes it lay nicely inside. Make sure you don't clip through your stitches. And then I sewed to my first point. I pushed it on the other side of my body, and then sewed from there down to here with a stretch stitch. And now this is like the easiest part. All you do is turn it right side out. You're gonna do that on both sides. Use a tube turner or I use chopstick to make a nice and pointy end on that end. And then all you have left on your halter ties is to slip stitch that closed, or you can even just use a zigzag. Nobody's probably gonna notice if you use a coordinating thread. And there you have it for that. Then we are going to get started on finishing our bottom band. So now we are ready to construct the band for the swim hook. And to do so, you're gonna get a marker or something and mark a point that is 1.5 inches away from the edge on both sides. And then we're gonna fold the band where the right sides are together like this on the long way. And we are going to stitch on either side using a 3/8 inch seam allowance from the one end to that point. So we're just gonna stitch 1.5 inches on each side. And then after we stitch it, we're gonna clip up to where our stitch line is, and I'll show you that. So it's just a really easy stitch. Okay, here is what it looks like stitched, if you can see that. And now I'm gonna take a sharp pair of scissors and I'm gonna cut right up to where my stitches end and as close to them as I can get, but not through them. And I'm gonna do that on both sides. So that is what that looks like. And I did on both sides. And now you're going to turn it to where the band is right side out. And since you made that clip, now you have, it's gonna look like this on both ends, so that you can attach from this point to the same point on the other end to the bottom of your top, your swim top. So go ahead and push that seam allowance out like this, and then that one's finished. So now take your band, if you didn't already, which I hadn't yet, go ahead and mark your center, the center of it, so it's easier to know how far to stretch, and line that up with the bottom of your, on your top. So you're gonna line it up with the bottom here, and we're gonna apply this band right sides together with our top, just like we normally would. Okay, so I have my center points marked, and I'm gonna put it right, I'm gonna put my band where the wrong sides are touching and the right side is out, and then I'm going to put it right side down onto the bottom of my swim top, and I'm gonna apply it. You just wanna make sure that it's all along the bottom, that you're not catching the crossover if you did the crossover, and there shouldn't be any stretching. See, it's pretty much just one for one, and we're gonna apply starting here, right sides together. So you're going to go ahead and serge this band on. Once it's on, we can fish our elastic through the tunnel of it, and we'll be ready to put on our swim clip. I fished my elastic through, and I just wanted to show you before we do the swim hook that you're going to need to tack that elastic down so it doesn't get lost in your casing. But you don't want to tack it all the way at the end, because then it's going to be really hard to fold this over your swim hook or to catch it. So you want to actually do it just right outside of that casing, like over here. So once you have it fished to where you want it, it's really scary to like let go of it, because you're thinking, oh my goodness, if I don't have something in there, I might lose it. So just keep, you might even want to, one thing you can do is pin it underneath there. So you're just going to do some zigzags to just kind of tack it down in place. And then I'll be right back and we'll just do the swim hook. Okay, so I've tacked down my elastic. And while I was there, I tacked down the seam and where you connect the band to the body, just so that it doesn't flip up. So I tacked that down. And now on one side, all you're going to do is fold the band to the wrong side like this to create like a loop. And then you're just going to tack it right down with a zigzag stitch again, right where you sewed before. So that's on one side. So I'm going to put a clip there so I'm ready for my machine. And then on the other side, I'm going to get my swim hook. And on your swim hook, you're going to make sure that the hook part is facing down. You don't want to hook. Let me make sure. Yes, you want to hook down. So you're going to put the pink band in the circle or oval part, and then you're going to put this here, and then you're going to hook this way. So I'll show you again from this angle. So I'm going to also tack this down in the same. So I'm going to put a clip there. So you see what this is going to look like.